Hi and welcome to this, another one of the Tech Geeks videos. Today we're going to be doing a how-to. This is going to be how to run two gates or two doors from one hub. Now we're going to be using the UA-Hub-Gate. There are some very specific caveats to making this work. I'm going to try and cover as many questions that people have asked us and show you how these can operate as independent gates and doors, even in Unifi Identity in the app. But please, do hear what I'm saying very clearly. This is the gate hub. This has a very, or the hub gate, whichever way you want to call it, this has a very definite difference to the other UA hubs. So traditionally, as you know, we need to have a Unifi controller, something like the UCG Max or a UDM Pro. And then to that, we need to have our PoE switch. From the PoE switch, we're going to connect to a hub. We generally need one of these per door. Unless you want to open all the doors at the same time, but if you want to independently manage them, then you normally need a hub per door. There's the hub mini as an option, there's the hub door, and then the one we're going to be looking at is a hub gate. Now this is very slightly different. This allows two different doors or gates to be opened independently. It's very unique at this point in recording this in April 2025. But let me just show you what is different about this. Let me just prop this down here. I'm going to show you how this all fits together in due course. But if you want to, this is designed for gates. But the one thing unique about this hub is we have our gate controllers here. But we also have a secondary door slash gate controller here. The key is this is the only one that is powered. These ones here are dry. This means that you need to already have a gate or door controller that has a power source already supplied to it and has a switch option built into it that allows this device to essentially send the open and close option. So there are some door openers, there are some door strikes and some mag locks that have that option fitted in. So if you have that on the doors, then you can effectively open not just only gates, but you could open two different doors on this. But if you're going to use this for a gate and a side door, your gate is generally going to have your manufacturer's gate opener. Maybe this is a roller shutter. Maybe it is also going to be a swing gate or something like, or even a slide gate. That will generally have a controller with it already, and it will have two terminals on it that allow you to send the same as you if you flick a light switch if you like, but we're not actually completing the circuit by sending voltage, we're just completing the circuit and then the system, the controller does all of that. If you have that option for your door as well, then you could use this instead of opening a gate, this could open a door. But the key thing down here is we have this separate 12 volt supply which we use for our side gate, so we can essentially have a gate opening and a side door all from the same hub. So I'm actually going to show you how this all fits together and works and how you can control this independently from the app. So let's start by putting all of this together. I'm going to use a PoE injector to do this. It's meant to be PoE++. I'm just going to use an 80 injector. We are in a minute going to add also this. This is a G3 intercom. Some people have asked us, can you set separate pin codes for the different doors? So if I was to put a pin code in here, would it unlock just one of the gates or one of the doors? So we're going to try that out as well. So our key here is obviously we are going to have a few cables. I've got a Ethernet cable here. This Ethernet cable is going to plug in to the LAN side of our PoE injector here, which is this side here. And we'll run this red cable. I've got a red cable over here while everything falls on the desk, as you can hear. And that's going to run from the PoE port on our injector there to the PoE in port of the top of the hub. Remember, the hub must be connected to a PoE switch or a PoE injector. You can't connect these directly to a switch. They need to be connected to the hub. I've also just got off the screen here a power bar. So I'm just going to connect this up. This Ethernet cable goes out to my network switch that my UNVR that we're going to control is plugged into. So now you can actually see that that is starting up. So we're going to hop on over to the computer and hopefully then get the rest of this set up and show you how it all works and how we can get this going independently as well. Okay, so I've just jumped around to my computer. We have got this logged in to my UNVR. This is my console that I'm using. UNVR can do protect and access. And you can see our new gate hub here is waiting to be adopted. So if you do this the first time, this has already been used in my test environment, so it has already updated to the latest firmware. But if you do that straight from the box, you'll probably find that it'll take a little bit longer because it'll need to do a factory update as well to the latest firmware. Now, the first thing that we get here, as you can see, is our little exclamation mark that's saying we need to finish off the config. Why is that? Well, it's very simple. This is designed for a number of gate opening options. And like I said before, you have to have a controller on there. First lot of terminals that we showed you there that were in gray, you need to have a gate opener or a door opener that already has a controller on it. This can't complete a 12 volt circuit with those. This is literally going to be sending an open or to the open or close input. So it wants us to know what are we going to do with this. And so I want this to actually be dealt with by the gate hub. And I'm just going to set those features in place. You'll choose that depending on what type of gate or door you're working. And you can see what happens here. So I want it to auto close after a minute, but you can bring that down to, you know, 15 seconds, a bit like the normal door entry. And we've got a few other features on there, because we saw we had two gate operators. So we might have a boom gate on, you know, one on either side, or what happens when it opens and closes if there are two options. On my side gate here, again, what do we want to actually happen? This unlocks, we're gonna set this to the same as the other at 15 seconds, and it'll leave the terminal open. What I'm gonna do on here, we can see, I'm gonna just try and name this main gate, just so that we can see this, and we'll leave that as the side door, just so we can see it's defined there as we need it. So let's just have a look, main gate and side door. So those are our two features set up. As you can see, you've got options here for siren and that, but that's not really the idea of this video. The idea of this video is to show you how this can be managed independently. And you can see over here that we've already got these options. So if I was already in Access, I could click on here and choose Unlock. Should have hopefully just seen on the screen there, there was an unlock that happened on there as separate. And if I was to maybe choose the side door again, I can send an unlock command to that in a different way. So just inside Access, immediately I can see these listed as two separate entities and manageable in two separate entities. For some people, they're just maybe going to keep the gate hub, the hub gate, and that's all that it's going to be for you here. It did just reset itself. Let's just do the main gate, for instance. If we unlock it, and we'll see after 15 seconds, we'll probably just see another or hear another click in just a moment. When it then sends that, it stops and sends us essentially the closed cycle for it. Just wait one moment. There you go, it said the last bit of the close on it. So we can manage these completely independently. This will carry all the way through to Unifi Identity, and I'll show you how that works as well in a moment. For some people, like I was just about to say, you may just decide you want the hub, you're not gonna have any readers or anything added to it. This is literally just for managing it, and you're gonna use the Unifi Access app, or you're going to use the Unifi Identity app to do it. Well, let's just step through the couple of things you need to do to make that actually work. You need to add the users that are actually going to have access to this. So let's go into the main gate, for instance. We'll talk about managed pairs or paired devices in a moment. We can choose our door attendants. So remember, this is if we don't have any, we're not intending to have any reader or intercom. I'm gonna add the intercom in a moment, which will give some different controls for pin access and everything else. But this is if you just wanted to use the hub with nothing else connected. So you can see here, I'm gonna add Paul and Jared. And the option to apply that is just under my name, so I'll do that. And that was the main gate, but maybe the side gate, I want to have a different set of people connected to that. And I'm actually gonna choose Toby and Paul. So we can now independently control who actually has access to that in their app as well. So in a moment, that will follow on through to Unifi Identity. which I'll show you in a moment. I do seem to think it takes about, if you're using Unifi Identity, it seems to take about 3 or 4 minutes before that's truly updated in Identity. Obviously in the Access app, which I'll show you in a moment, it's there straight away, and you can use it, but Identity seems to take a little bit further to come through. Just another quick look here. So select paired devices. So these are your paired devices that you might want to connect with this. So what can you do with this? This is where maybe I've got a front door camera, and when I want someone, when somebody pushes, when I maybe unlock the gate, I want it to actually make an action of recording what's actually happening on that gate at the same time. And so I can pair a number of devices, and recording will happen immediately at that point in time. So if I can save this up as a paired device, then we'll see what's actually going to happen at that moment in time. So let's just look at a couple of extra things in here. So we do have the options here to be able to disable a door from being usable. That means it will going to disappear in the app. Maybe you only want to use one of them, or maybe for some reason you want to just for a period of time stop access to one of the gates. So you can use that as an option. And then we've got paired devices, and paired devices are really interesting. So paired devices are devices that you want to actually, in this instance, at the moment, in this where I've recorded this, to be able to actually interact when something happens. So in this instance, I maybe got a front camera and a front fence camera. I want to join these to this main door in here. And what happens now when I have my main door, let me just see where I've paired those to. Hang on a minute, I've probably paired that. Here we go, we've paired these to the main gate. And what this basically means now is that when I do an action on that main gate, maybe I click the door hub I unlock it, or I choose to lock it, it will start recording from those cameras as well. So I get this extra level of interaction between this and Protect. So that's just our extra things that happen on there. And if I want to remove those again, then I can just untick those from and save. So that's what we do with the managed devices in there. And that's sort of, again, all of what we can actually do now with inside the app itself. So if I actually jump onto the app for Unifi Access, and just quickly show you this in Unifi Access and in Unifi Protect. So if we go into Unifi Access directly, you can see we've now got our UA-Hub-Gate in here, and we can click here, and this will allow us to manage both of those doors individually. We can tap unlock if we wanted to on that one. We can do it independently on the side door as well. So we know in Unifi app, in the Unifi Access app, it works just in the same way. If we look at Unifi Identity, and like I said to you, it takes about 3 or 4 minutes, maybe a restart of the app for it to appear. But we can now see we've got our main gate as a control and our side gate, and we can control those independently. So in the app, if we were just now going to use the hub, no other integrations, we can control a gate with its own controller. It could even be a roller shutter, but it needs its own controller, like I said. And this is just going to be the on-off switch, no 12 volts. And we've got a side gate that can have a normal mag lock or can have a normal electronic strike, and that will be powered by 12 volts. So we've now got to that stage. Now what we'd like to do is, because I had quite a few questions, what can we do now? We can see that we can do these independently. I'm now just gonna go in here go back to here and remove the attendants from this, because now we're going to add these in from adding in a G3 intercom, and then we're going to be able to manage these separately from that point. And I just want to see, can we do separate pin codes to unlock the doors or when we're using the intercom itself? Or is our independent management of those doors only if we've got the app? So let's head on back to our setup and we get a few of those things connected together. Okay, so we're just gonna now take our G3 intercom and we're going to actually plug this into our hub. Again, like I said, this can't be done independently. This needs to be plugged into a hub to manage it. So hopefully let's just bring that into place and we can actually see as we set that up. And that should now power up and we can hop back to our computer and now add that and hopefully see what else we can do with it. All right, so we're just gonna now wait, just gonna have a couple of minutes, just gonna see what can happen here for adopting this. So we just need to wait for this to have powered up. And then once that's powered up, hopefully we will be able to adopt the intercom into the setup. And we can just have a quick look at what other options are here. So we're just gonna give this a further moment to get to where it needs to. There we go. So here now the new hub has appeared. So we're just gonna click to adopt that. I would imagine it's gonna probably need a few updates. I don't want to use TouchPass at the moment, which works for your Apple Watch, your Apple phone and Google and stuff like that. But I just want to get this device in and connected up. So let's just wait for that to adopt into the setup. Okay, we can see this is called main gate entry on here. I'm not sure now, you can see it's getting a video of my setup that's recording it at the moment. We'll just quickly put this into an update so we do have the latest features and we'll just need to hop back to that in a moment. It's just gonna take a few minutes to update that. As soon as update, we'll come back and we'll see what options we have. Okay, so what we can see now is the main entry has now updated. You can see a video there feed up onto the top of the rig that I'm using to record this on. So what we can see is that if we actually have a look in the settings for the hub gate here, let me just go back to here a moment. Sorry, let's go back into the actual intercom. And into settings, we can see we've got options here to be able to set our PIN code, our face recognition. But the questions, like I said, that we're asked are, can you use two separate PINs and to open the gates independently of each other or doors independently? Well, what we can actually see, if we have a look here, we can see that this is paired. So this intercom is paired with the main gate. If we go back to the UA hub here, the hub gate, and actually choose the side door and then try and select this gate intercom again and choose save, you can see it want to unpair, disconnect the G3 intercom from the main gate and move it to the side gate. So in this instance, what we can see is that you can have two independently controlled doors or gates, obviously with the caveat that it needs its own gate controller or a dry contact, and the side gate can have 12 volts if needed. But one reader or one intercom or one G3 Reader Pro, whatever you fit there, can only control one of the gates itself. So if you wanted to control two of them, you're going to need either a second intercom or maybe a G3 Reader Pro on there as an option as well. You can connect that to the same hub and then you'd be able to independently, if put a pin in for each one of them, and control those two doors. But you would have to do that with an individual access device for each door. So hopefully that answers a few questions. What we've gone through there, as you can see, we can change the attendants. If we just want to use the hub on its own, we can therefore use access and the identity app to manage the doors or gates and open them independently. If we wanted to add them like we've done an intercom, then that works. But the caveat is that you need one access reader or intercom style solution for each gate if you want to uniquely have a user put in a PIN code or open those independently without using the app. So hopefully that has been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. Got plenty more how-to guides, box openings. Hopefully you'll find some useful information there. So subscribe and stay up to date.